Hey guys, it's Friday, end of the week, October 27th, sorry, I had to think about it, 2023. Today's going to be Navy SEALs Day, 20 minutes. The plan is to make the best with what I have today. Pretty worn out. A couple decent sessions, my last Navy SEAL session, which was on I guess Tuesday. They got 110 reps, which is pretty good. About the best that I've done in well over a month, if not maybe closer to 2 months. So I'm pretty happy with that. A couple decent 6 count sessions in the 230s. Not great, but not bad. Getting the reps in. However, I'm just feeling worn out, tired, sore. You know, something that I work for, I earn. So, with that in mind, I'm just sort of going to lower the expectations. Whatever I get over 100 reps, assume I can get 100 reps, is going to be absolutely fine today. The strategy is going to be continue what I've been doing, chasing the fives for 10 minutes, chasing fours for 10 minutes. So, last time, I saved up 2 minutes in my first 10 minutes, which was pretty awesome, which means that I got 60 reps in that first 10. And then I switched down to fours, and I got 2 minutes with the fours, which is awesome as well. So I was able to get in that extra four at the second to last minute, bringing me all the way up to 104, and then I pumped out 6 reps in the very last minute, giving me 110. So it was a good session, basically what I'm saying. And I don't know what to expect for today, but I'm not feeling great. Not bad, just not great. Alright, diving right into it. Oof.
Oof. Three.
121 counting. No, 131 counting the one pumps. 111 Navy SEALs. I managed to save 2 minutes with my first 10-minute sets of five. Not easy. I was fairly spent after that. And then I settled in for the slog with the fours. I was able to save 2 minutes.
I got five reps on my last
second to last minute. Should have been a four. I went ahead
and got that extra rep, although I was afraid
it might cost me and I might only be able to get five my last minute,
but I was able to get six
right on the cusp.
Not a second to spare.
As a matter of fact, technically speaking, I was not quite standing up. When I got that sixth rep in.
One second, guys.
That was tough. I'll be honest with you. I don't think I could have slipped another rep in anywhere in there. That was right. Right at the edge. Attempting another rep would have been full step over the line. However, I threaded the line straight down the middle. I got one rep more. So, good day. Would have been a good day with 110. It would have been a good day with 108. It would have been a good day with 100. I wrote this morning, and I'll use it in one of my shorts. I've been in a deep study of Patanjali's Yoga Sutras the past few months. And it's always been a reference book for me for decades, but I've dove straight in, immersed myself in it. And he only talks about asanas, the postures, three times in the entire 100 and, now I don't remember how many sutras, I think 130 something. Maybe 140 something. But he only mentions the asanas three times. And of course, that's what we all associate yoga with. If somebody says, I do yoga, we'll ask, what studio, what style? That kind of question. Assuming they're talking about the postures. Which, you know, again, the seminal handbook on yoga mentions the asanas three times. And they only mention in regards to meditation postures, to hold your posture steady, comfortable, steadfast, and that way you can concentrate on the meditation, on the mantra. And of course, we take that to mean all kinds of other things. Now, when we're doing our regular asana practice, we want to keep that in mind. We want to hold our postures steady, steady as we can. That's the training. It's the same with yoga, although it's motion. So we think, well, how do you hold something steady when it's motion? And the answer is we hold our mind steady. We're at ease within the motion. We're comfortable with the discomfort. So we are not shaken by what's going on. There's no panic. You know, oh my God, I'm only going to get 109 reps, one less than I got last time, and then doubling down and being worse off. You set that intuitive, spontaneous, I'm going to take each minute as it comes. When the time is right, if I'm able, I'm going to offer a sprint. If I can't, I'll hold steady. If I can't, I'll make an adjustment. What was the quote from Siviana? Adopt, adjust, and accommodate. That's the path of yoga. And it's all yoga, including burpees. So in our burpee practice, 20 minutes and half an hour, in whatever we're doing, we adjust. And we, I just said it, I have it written down. Adapt, adjust, accommodate. Pretty simple. I have written down to remind myself before every set. I glance at it, and that's my practice. Doesn't matter how many reps I get, as long as I do those three things, keeping it spontaneous. Spontaneous, I don't mean, you know, frivolous. I mean that each moment is going to present its own unique opportunities and drawbacks. And you maneuver through each moment the best that you can. So today, it was a pretty good job of it. Who knows, tomorrow, doesn't really matter. I will see you guys later this afternoon. We'll talk some more about this probably. And take care, enjoy your Friday, guys.